Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see about budget outlook, like what are the highlight things we need to note down from the budget. By knowing these highlights and knowing this what are the winning and losers from the budgets, you can trade on your own. For that, this video will be very helpful for you. Those who are new to channel, kindly subscribe the channel and select the ring bell. If you feel like the video, kindly select the like button and share it. By selecting the name of this channel, NSE Commodity Trader, you will go to the home page. In home page, you can see more strategy videos, indicator videos. By watching this video, you can gain more knowledge about market also. We are also taking more advanced trading strategy class, and we are also providing levels for commodity also. If you want to know about these details, means you can WhatsApp or contact the number which is given below the video. Let's take a look at Nifty, what happened in the Nifty outlook. Actually, Nifty opened as a gap down. Within the 5 minutes, market came down very well. It breached 11,900. It traded at the range of 11,860. But market recovered very soon, and it gone up to 12,000 range also. After that, after 11 pm, up to 11 pm, market was in positive only, market near to 12,000 range. Like that only market traded. But after the budget meeting started, Sitaraman started to announcement, step by step market started to falling. During that falling, every half an hour market falled 100 points. At the end of the market, it till the end of the market came very down to the end of the point also, 633. Due to the average concept, it closed at 660, but market has been touched the low of 633.30 paisa. Okay, so currently market is in as a very, very bearish day, very, very bearish candle, 300 points down for Nifty, 1000 point down for Sensex. Let's take a look at who are all the winner and losers in the market. In this, the main winner is transport infrastructure, because government has accelerated more infrastructure process, like it started to unveil more key plats, like they put more money into the infrastructure, because they started to have feel like infrastructure is important thing for a country to develop. Since we are trying to develop, they put more money, like around 1.7 trillion in rupees, if you can say 1.7 lakh crores has been, they are going to invest in this transport infrastructure. So from this, the key infrastructure players like L&T, KNR Construction, IRB Infra, they are the one going to get benefit. But who is going to win the project is the one going to get more benefit from this amount also. Okay, and then the next thing is electronic manufacturing, like the electronic manufacturers, like phone manufacturers, like that Dixon Technology, Amber Enterprises, those companies also going to get benefit, because they are going to encourage the manufacturing companies of mobile phones, and then the electronic equipment, semiconductor manufacturing, they are like medical devices also. So they are the ones, next one going to get benefits. And then the main important thing for rural India, because even before the project, they said we are going to focus more on rural India. So rural India, they are going to spend around 2.83 trillion rupees into the agriculture. They are expecting the target will be up to 15 trillion rupees. So it is like they are going to expand the fisheries and create 500 fish farmer producer organizations. So like that, they are going to, for non-veg sectors like Avanti Feed, Apex Frozen, and then Water Base, Venkis, they are all the companies related to the non-veg shares. So in symptoms I am saying non-veg, but it is oriented to the fishing farmers, like that. So these are the companies going to get the benefit from these rural concepts. So for fisheries, main thing, it will be non-veg shares like Avanti Feed, Apex Frozen, Water Base, Venkis India. So they are the companies going to get the benefit from them. And then the next thing is water, that is going to be boost the share of Wabag Limited, because they are going to put the pipeline, and they are going to extend it. So many of them will get water from them. So the main thing, Wabag is going to get benefit. Today market reacted very well for Shakti pumps also, because from the opening itself Shakti pump traded at 10% and it almost closed at the 20% during the end of the market. Today it closed at 20%, so it's a very very positive news for Shakti pumps. And then the next one is telecom. In telecom, they are going to spend 60 billion for BharatNet project. They are going to provide broadband for every village also. That is the $60 billion project. Many of them are saying the Reliance Industries and HFCL are going to get the benefit from this telecom. And then the next one is IT firm. Private sector are going to build the data center parks. For that, they are going to get the help from the government also. And then education. Education also going to be the main important key thing in this budget. For education, they are going to spend 993 billion rupees. That's a huge amount. And then the main thing they are going to spend for education is online system, like online teaching, online degree level courses. So they are going to spend more on like degree level courses on for educations. And then the next thing is gas pipeline. In gas pipeline expansion, they are going to expand another 27,000 kilometer. So it is another 10K they are going to add. Let's take a look at losers from the budget also, because we need to know what are all the negative things that happened in the market also. The first thing is, this is the positive news for LIC housing finance holder, but it is opposite for the other insurance companies. So let's take a look at what is the reason. Because government is planning to sell a stake in LIC through IPO. So it is a positive news for LIC housing finance, but not for the other insurance companies. Meanwhile, another thing that is going to negative news for the insurance company is, because many of them are saying you can get key benefit from the you can get key benefits, like you can use insurance as a tax benefit, like that they using as a selling tone for the insurance. But currently in the new slab that is going to be is up to 5 lakh you don't need to pay any income tax. If you are earning 5 lakhs per annum, means you don't need to pay any amount to the government. So there is the new slab. In old slab, only up to 2.5 lakh is the nil amount. Currently it extended up to 5 lakh, and they reduced for other things also. Previously 5 to 10 lakh they need to pay 20%. Currently 5 to 7.5 lakh 10% only. So it is 10% cut, and for 7.5 lakh to 10 lakh is 15% cut. Like that, up to 15 lakh every 5% they cut it. Previously above 10 lakh you need to pay 30% tax, but currently only 15 lakh above only you need to pay 30% of tax from your wealth of income. Okay, so these are all the main thing that is going to benefit for the common people, but not for the insurance companies. For insurance companies like HDFC Life, SBI Life, it is going to be the negative one only. And then the state run banks. Why a negative news for bank? They did actually, no announcement has been said anything about new capital they are going to infuse into the bank. Like before 2014 only, the government has induced some amount for the banks. Without fund, banks also cannot able to move well. So due to that news, there is no news for new infusion of capitals. That is affected the banks like SBI, Bank of Baroda, Canara Bank, Union Bank of India. Like this, they are all affected. And today market gone down because of the main reason of banking sector, like private bank, PSU bank. They are all the main reason today market gone down also, because they crashed the market more than 3% index. Index has been weighted more than 3% down. And then there is no new news has been announced for real estate also. They didn't focus anything for real estates also. So that is a negative news for real estate companies like DLF. Like those companies also got affected during this news. So they are the winner and loser for the budget of the highlights. But there is One another thing that is also a negative news for the market that came down, because many of them are expected the long-term capital gain tax will be removed from the market. So it is a huge expectation. And then DDT also has been expected to be abolished completely. But those things have not happened because Finance Minister Sitharaman didn't said anything about no news about LTCG. So it is affected the market because already media created like there will be a cut for LTCG, there will be some news for LTCG like that. Media buzzed the market and said many things like that. But due to there is no news from the LTCG, it negatively impacted the sentiments for the investors also. And then DDT has been removed, but it is going to be included for the income of the shareholder. So it is like a twist for the investors. So the DDT has been going to be removed from the companies only, but not for the income of the shareholders. For major shareholders, it is going to affect only. The DDT is going to be there only. So it is a negative news only, not such a positive news. We cannot say negative, we cannot say positive, but it is still a negative news only. So this DDT and LTCG affected the market majorly. After that only market started to falling down very well. So during that fall only it reached 300 points, more than 300 points loss for Nifty, 1000 points loss for Sensex also. Let's take a look at the index wise so you can have some idea. In index wise, if you take look, means Nifty Bank has gone down up to 3% loss. Auto sector 2.83, financial service 3.93, and then PSU bank, public sector bank 4%, and then Nifty media also 4%. Except Nifty IT, all sector got affected during this rally. Why after so many positive things market still came down? Means experts are saying it lacks funds to kickstart the economic growth because it is not pushing anything to like you can expect more from the economy. You can expect it is a firing budget like that because they are spending more on rural economy infrastructure that is expected, but it is not such a development process for a company, not such a development thing for a India, not Indian economy like that. It is just a small thing that they are filling that blank like that only it has happening. So due to that it is not such a big impressive thing. And then the main thing that is not the market is not moving well is that doing away of dividend distribution tax is a good measure for company's viewpoint, not for the investor. So it is still going to affect the investor, and there is no news for the long-term capital gain. So that is also affected the investor. The main one investing in the market is investor, but investor is not going to get anything from the budget. So it is a worst budget for the investors. Due to it is a worst budget for the investors, market got affected, everyone got sold in the market. During this just a single day, more than lakhs of crores has been reduced for many investors. Let's come back to Nifty. You can what are all the levels you can expect in the market? If Monday market opened as a gap down, means you just need to wait and observe the market. After the gap down, if market seen any recovery in the upside, means you can buy the Nifty and expect it in the upside. But if market opened as a gap down, you didn't see any recovery mode within 2 minutes, market is not recovering the gap, filling the gap, means if market is opening as a gap down, after that gap down market still going down, means don't do any buying at all in the Nifty, because that day going to be a another selling day, another bearish candle for the market only. So if there is a gap down and it's still the gap down is going on as a red color candle, means just go for selling, don't expect positiveness from the market also. If a gap down opened and market recovered, means you can buy it the Nifty and you can fill the gap has been will you can expect the positiveness from the market also. If there is a gap up opening, means you can buy the Nifty if you see recovery mode. After buying, you can just wait until the few minutes and confirm it. Before buying it, you need to confirm the whether the market is going to be a positive, because by seeing the candle you can get some idea either it is in green or red. Okay. So these are all the tips from me, and if you have more doubts, you can WhatsApp or contact me. We are also providing levels, we are also teaching advanced trading strategies also. If you want to know about these details means, you can WhatsApp or contact me. We are also providing levels for commodity also, like for crude oil, copper, zinc and gold. If you want to know about these details, you can WhatsApp or contact me. In future, if you want to see more videos like this means, kindly subscribe my channel and select the ring bell. Thank you.